In one form or the other, the free browser-based versions of Word, Excel, PowerPoint, and OneNote have been available for more than 5 years, now known as Office Online. Have you used them? Have you used them lately?
And if you've been using some other cloud services, which we won't mention at this moment, you'd be really surprised how easy Office.com or Office Online really is to use. Get up and start it. You can get up and running and for free in about a couple seconds. So,
well, that's what we're going to show, right? We're going to show that hopefully that's what's going to work for that. So we're going to start off, and let me switch my computer here over. And the main thing is where you start. And you start basically at office.com.
That's just it?
That's where you need to go. Office.com will bring you to this page, and then you can sign in. Now, I'm going to start with a brand new address. I didn't want to show you the boring sign-up procedure. I thought that would be kind of silly. I'll show you the page. It's a simple sign-up that you would do. Now, if you have an old Hotmail account, an Xbox Live account, a new Outlook.com, you already have a Microsoft ID. You can sign right in with those credentials. But we wanted to start from scratch, so I'm just going to sign in here in the upper right-hand corner. I could just click on an icon and start. But I want to show you that I'm going to begin with a Gmail address. And I just kind of type that in, and I'll sign in here and use Office Online.
So you could have put that Gmail address in that sign-up form you just showed us a second ago and use that as your login ID.
Use that as your login. Wow. So when you come to Office Online, or Office.com, I should say, you can click on anything. Let's open up a Word document. And you can start with a blank document, but I want to show you some of the great templates we have here. So just like you find for the regular Word, we have these great-looking templates. Let's go ahead. I'm going to pick this event flyer one. And I want to open it in Word Online. Now, again, I don't have to have Office on my computer. I don't have to pay anything. I'm just here, and I'm starting using this. And it doesn't matter which browser. Any updated browser should work. I'm on Internet Explorer, Safari, Chrome, Firefox. All this stuff will work. I can grab more templates, but I want to continue. And here I am with working on, in Internet Explorer, a browser, I'm working with Word. Now, this looks and feels like Word 2013. I got plenty of the stuff up here in the ribbon that I can work on. Again, I can just, let's say I'm going to do a summer bash.
No, wait a minute. I don't believe you. This is Word. This is just Word,
no,
right?
This,
the Word program.
No, this is Word Online. See it, upper left-hand corner? I'm in a browser. I'm in Internet Explorer.
Wow, it really looks so much like the Word program.
Right. And if you have an older version of Word, like Word 2010, it's not going to look the same. This is the new look of Word 2013. But you can see I could insert tables. I could insert pictures, picture layout. I could go, you know, I could change this to a landscape if I wanted to. Now, it doesn't
Can you do mail merge?
You can't do mail merge. You can't do, if you're looking with
indexes,
stuff, indexing, bibliography, none of that hard, heavy lifting stuff. But the basics of what you want to use, and probably even more than the basics, you'll be able to find here. So, yeah, I'm going to do this, I guess, a summer bash with windmills. It's going to be a very green party,
kind of
I guess.
Environmental.
kind of environmental part of that. So that's working with Word and starting off from scratch. And again, just clicking an icon at office.com and going. But let's do this scenario. Let's go over and show you OneDrive here. So OneDrive is where everything is stored in for your Word documents. Now, you can store any type of documents here. You get 7 gigabytes of storage. You can see I have 6.99 available here in the bottom left-hand corner. That's because that template I've just stored here, it just automatically stores.
Where is it?
It's right here under Documents. Here, I'm going to show you two views.
Okay.
Some people like this more traditional view. And under Documents, it's just Document because I didn't name the document. But that's it. See, if I punch it, it's that document. It's going to say Summer Bash. See?
So it all just gets collected there at the OneDrive location.
Exactly.
Okay,
so
cool.
7 gigabytes of storage you can store. We'll show you later. Pictures, text files, PDFs, anything you want to store. It doesn't have to be Office documents. But let's say that someone I'm working with had a PowerPoint, and I don't have PowerPoint. So I'm going to open this up. I'm going to upload this presentation that I have from email. I put it on my desktop, and I'm going to put it into OneDrive here. I'm going to upload it, and there it is.
There it is. Okay,
okay.
Got it.
And now I'm going to click on that, and this will open up PowerPoint Online. And again, it's going to look and feel like PowerPoint 2013, and here it is. I could view this presentation. It's even got some of the animations.
And okay, that's amazing.
Yeah.
Because before, in the old days, when you had a PowerPoint file and you wanted to send it to someone, you had
to... Oh my gosh, yeah.
put it on a CD, or you had to have them download the PowerPoint reader, or you had to have them, you saved it as another format, but now you just send them a link to this.
You send them a link. That's one of the cool things, is you send them a link instead of sending out a document and sending multiple copies, and then you send it to 10 people and they mail it all back
right,
to you.
Right, right.
There's one copy, it's on there, and we're going to show you how to share that right now. So let me go over and hit the share button up here. And I'm going to send this to Dave. I don't know where Dave is. He could be on vacation, sitting on a beach. We always say that. He's, of course, just right there next to me.
I wish.
Agenda needs help. Okay. So I'm going to send this off, and I can give you a couple different options. So down here, it's the default setting is that people can edit. But if you just want them to view, you can change that. So again, if you just want someone to view your slides, or present them. They can present with PowerPoint Online. You can do that. And then if you want to have a little more protection, they can have to sign in with a Microsoft account. They don't have to, though. Again, you can send stuff to folks, and you don't have to think about what computer they have or what device they have. Dave happens to be on an iPad.
Or even they don't even need to have an account, it looks
right,
like.
Right, exactly.
Just get up and running right away.
Yep. Okay. So let me go ahead and send this to you.
All right.
And you can get it in mail. And there's other ways you can send. If you just want to send people a link, you can. So you can create a sharing link. Now, the thing with links is you can IM that, or you can send it even in text if you wanted to, or share it Facebook, Twitter. The thing is, if the link, anyone could copy and paste and use the link, so you want to be a little careful. But you control the sharing. So this link is active. I'll go over here to the left-hand side, click on it, and now down here I can just remove that link. So that link now... Only Dave now can edit this document along with myself.
Yeah, that's really easy.
So, and then I'm going to edit this presentation. Up in the left-hand side here, I can edit this in PowerPoint if I have PowerPoint. PowerPoint 2010 would work. PowerPoint 2007 would work. Or the latest version of PowerPoint, Office 365, would work. But I'm going to do this online. And as I do this, you got an email.
Yes, I did. So I got an email here from Doug. It says, D. Thomas has shared a document with you. And I'm going to go ahead and tap the link to open it. And it will open up in the same way it opened on Doug's computer. It's opening up in PowerPoint Online.
So he's going to see the same thing that I'm going to see. Now, again, because we're online, because we're on different browsers, different computers will look a little differently. Some will look better than others. But again, that's what happens when you have multiple different types of devices and multiple different types of browsers. We'll shift this over to something else that's a little better in just a moment. But let's just show you how things work. So I'm on here, and you can see in the upper right-hand corner, it now says Dave Ludwig is also editing.
Yep.
So I can see that he's in there. And I said, well, if you go to the agenda slide, try to help me out. And
yeah, sure. I'm on the agenda slide here. I'm going to make a change. In fact, I am going to, instead of saying shared vision, I'm going to say shared goals here.
Okay. So you can see this paragraph has now got this orange box around it, and that's where he's editing this document. Again, this is all just done in real time since everyone's on the browser. We've experimented with this before. We've had a couple dozen people in a document at one time. And there it is. Shared goals is now updated on my computer. So that's one way to do it as a browser, but with an iPad, you got even a better way to work on this.
Indeed you do. Yeah. I'm going to go back up here to the View tab and hit Reading View, and then I'm going to be able to relaunch it into PowerPoint for iPad. How do I do that? So I go up here and I tap Edit Presentation.
Just like what I did,
yep. Mine. And instead of saying Edit in PowerPoint Online, I say Edit in PowerPoint. And because I have PowerPoint for iPad installed, it will open it up here in PowerPoint for iPad.
Pray tell, Dave, how did you get Office for iPad?
Well, what I did, Douglas, is I went to the App Store and I downloaded PowerPoint for iPad. And it's free if you just want to read and present files. But if you want to actually edit them, it takes a subscription.
Yeah, so any subscription to Office 365, or if your business or your school has an account, you can use that, and that way you can edit. But again, anyone can download them for free and view stuff in a format that's designed for iPad.
Right. Like, so, you know, for a moment ago, I was in the web browser in Safari, and I was opening this file and editing it, and that worked pretty good. But with the iPad app for PowerPoint, it is much better. So you can pinch and zoom. You can touch through the slides. You can navigate like you would on an iPad. with the PowerPoint for iPad.
So go ahead and edit here. Now, as you can see on the PC here, it says now it's gray up here that David Ludwig is also editing. And I'm not going to get the box that I did before. I'm not going to figure out where he is in the document. It's just, again, he's on a program. I'm on the browser. Things are going to work a little differently, but I don't know what you're going to change, but we'll find out in just a moment here when it updates. But one thing about, now, when you co-author a document, often you're not working on the same slide. But the scenario that happens all the time for us, especially a couple years ago with online documents, is you say, okay, at 2 o'clock I have to get in there and work on this document that everyone's working on. And you try to open it up and it says it's locked because somebody, like, I'm trying to get in and Dave, it's locked by Dave. And so it's like, wait a minute, I have to work on this now. It's the only time I have during the day to do this. But I either have to, if I know Dave, I can call him up and say, can you please get out? And a lot of times it was like, oh, sorry, I forgot that it was still open.
Yeah, or you had something due and you had to go ahead and like get it done by 5 o'clock, but poor somebody, you know, Doug had it open and it said, this file is locked for editing, you cannot do this. That's not the case anymore.
Right.
Co-authoring gets around all that.
So again, you can be in the same document at the same time, and again, you can have multiple people in there for it. Now it looks like this maybe is not, oh, there it is.
Yeah.
So there it is. Oh, and shared goals, big part of the. Thanks for helping me with the agenda. That was
sure.
That was
well, I
really
like to
sharp.
Point out the important things. So,
so that's sharing with a OneNote, and I'm sorry, sharing with OneDrive and Office Online. Let's go. I want to do a little bit more about OneDrive to show you a few things off. And to do that, what I want to do is, and there's the company presentation there, but I'm going to sign out of here really quick, and I'm going to sign in and show you kind of a full-baked version of OneDrive. So this is my OneDrive. I have many different things that I've put in here, photos, documents, a whole bunch of stuff that I can get to. One of the features that I want to talk about is photos, because that's what a lot of people do with OneDrive, is to share photos and work with photos. One of the things you can do if you have a smartphone, and I have a Windows phone, but this works with you can get an app, a OneDrive app for Android phones and for iPhones, and you can get it so you can have basically it's automatic backup. So I'm going to take a picture of our fabulous web crew. They didn't know they were going to have their picture taken. There we go. And if, as long as I'm connected to a Wi-Fi network, this will upload automatically. We'll see how fast that happens. But you can do that with your any photos and upload them to OneDrive. Again, you get 7 gigabytes for free. If you do other things, if you get your phone, if you get the app, I think you get 3 gigabytes. If you get an Office Online account, you get 20 gigabytes. And you can also purchase more storage if you want to. So
wait, let me back up.
Yeah.
What did you do just then?
Okay.
You, on your phone, you said, yes, I want to back up my photos to OneDrive.
Yeah, it's a setting on the phone that just says automatic backup. And again, if you get an iPhone or Android and just download the free OneDrive app, you can set the same up for your camera too, so it'll automatically upload your photos, as I have here with a plethora of photos.
So when you take a picture,
yeah,
it says, oh, you need to back up this photo. I'm going to do that for you. And if you're on Wi-Fi,
it just does it.
It sends it up to OneDrive.
It just does it.
Okay.
So, and then since we have just a moment before we, and let me just show you one other feature. If you have a Windows 8 computer or Windows 8.1, you can actually get a OneDrive app. This is all set up for touch. You can go in and edit documents. You can edit pictures. Whoops. So there was the updated photo here that I just made. So I'll click on that one. There we are. There's our fabulous crew. I'm not going to hit the delete button, but I
guess
I could.
We didn't warn them about
it. Yeah, we didn't warn them about the picture. Let's go ahead. But again, this app for Windows, which is built into Windows 8 and 8.1, has a lot of different tools, including editing tools. Here's a beautiful glass of lemonade I made this weekend, but I realized it was...
that looks tasty.
It was quite tasty. You can do some basic fixes, like here, I realized it wasn't straight, so I can go ahead and use these photo tools with my finger and just make it so it's a nice straight picture and save it that way. So lots of different tools you can use. Lots of different apps for various devices that you can use with OneDrive. So we'll give you links for that. You can download OneDrive for any, you know, for Macs, PCs, Windows, even Xbox. You can view your pictures on your giant screen at home through your Xbox if you want to. So you can download OneDrive for various devices, and we have all those links for you. And where do you find those links? Well, you can go to our page, at aka.ms/00123. That's our short link for today's webinar. We have all the links there. The video will be up there in a couple days. Information about the Office webinar series in general, you can go to aka.ms/offweb. Next week, you need to register in advance. It takes all of 15 seconds. You can go to our main page or this page for Simplifying Outlook. That's next week. But for today's webinar crew, thank you for joining today's Office 15-Minute Webinar.